A report released by the Calgary Catholic Immigration Society shows 83 Filipino families were involved in domestic violence, child abuse, and drug abuse cases. So Calgary authorities have urged community leaders and social workers to do something about the issue. Quay Evano reports.
Economic recession, cultural differences, and the financial stress of sending money back home top the reasons why Filipino family cases are up with local authorities in Calgary. Many are from the Live-in Caregiver and Temporary Foreign Workers Program.
So yung sinasabi nating hiwalayan, hiniiwan mo na ng nanay o ng tatay ang pamilya tapos saka lang kinukuha dito. Pero during those years na magkahiwalay, maraming problema at maraming nangyayari na pag dumating sila dito at nagsasama-sama, may problema at may issue na hindi na-resolve.
Different social service organizations are now working with Filipino community leaders to help Pinoy families.
We wanted to educate the seniors, letting them be more aware of the issues in the community. So para naman, we can share that information. Tapos ang next step would be, we would be gathering the community leaders, faith-based group, yung mga youth programs na may mga leaders dyan. Hopefully, in 3 years, we want to see this number going down.
The Alberta Child and Family Services is also trying to have children in their care, placed with caretakers in the community who share their culture.
We know that if children remain in their community, they will do better. So we've looked at cultural kinship as a program where we would ask people from a specific culture, such as the Filipino culture, to come forward and be approved to be a kinship home in our system.
But some kababayan say the high numbers of cases involving Pinoy families may be misleading. Alberta Child and Family Services took away the Raymundo's son after nurses mistook his bruises due to a metabolic bone disease as a sign of physical abuse. They were separated for 18 months. But with support of friends and free legal aid, they were able to get back their children last year.
Pero yung mga batang ilayo mo sa magulang, tapos hindi ka naman sigurado, di ba, kung ano talaga yung nangyari. Sabi ko nga, bakit yung mga bata na talagang sinasaktan ng magulang, nasa kanila pa rin. Pero ikaw, yung anak mo yung hindi dapat nawala sa'yo, sila pa yung nawawala.
The Raymundos want local authorities to really investigate the cases and be aware that some cases might be different.
Sanay tayo ng oo lang ng oo kasi iniisip mo sila yung authority. But dito, sa case namin, natuto kaming lumaban, natuto kami, not in an aggressive way, but you have to be assertive and you have to stand for your right, diba?
For many Filipinos, migrating to Canada is a dream come true. But the hard reality of making a living and raising a family in a new country with different cultures and laws can take a toll. Quay Evano, ABS-CBN News, Calgary.